their purple uniforms trimmed in gold, Indiana in their home white. And how about that for a start? Picking up where she left off, Peyton Carter made 4 3-pointers in the first quarter the other night. She hits the first one. The leading scorer, Malia Owens for Tennessee Tech. Nice pass inside. Grace Berger, number 2 all-time in assists in Indiana history. The leader sets up Meister for the score.
Indiana's loves to rebound and run, and they run the floor hard and just finds the open. Berger just makes a great pass.
33 for Tennessee Tech is Reagan Grimes. Too strong. And here comes Grace Berger. Grace Berger steps through. Left-hand finish. What a crowd here on hand at Assembly Hall, but not fazed at all. Malia Owens hits a three. As we mentioned, Tennessee Tech started off hot against Monmouth, but it wasn't against this crowd. There were just a few fans here in attendance, but Sydney Parrish with a nice answer for Indiana. Yeah, in the incredibly potent Big Ten Conference, Indiana only trails Iowa, but how about that? Reagan Grimes going to get in on it.
And Grimes says, you know what, I'm going to step out. I'm not going to go inside. I can shoot the three on my own.
He gets her first basket in this game from three. Berger takes it in, and a blocking foul called on Grimes. Indiana with 11-9 lead in the early going. But, boy, Tennessee Tech is not showing that they are intimidated at all. Jada Gwynn ties it up.
Tennessee Tech jumps into the press. They want to try to get Indiana late in their shot clock.
Garzone with a beautiful move, the freshman.
Yeah, good ball movement by Tennessee Tech. Just we going in and out side to side.
Owens for another three-pointer straight away.
Very patient bringing their offense, Tennessee Tech. Nice move.
All the way to the hoop. Grace Berger, all Big Ten selection 4 straight years. Jordan Brock taps the top of her head, pulls up for a jumper over Parrish. Wow, great jumper from the grad student.
Great hands, great defense.
Kiera Hill blocked by Meister. Meister is cleaning things up inside, but good extra effort from Hill. She does not get a lot of time behind Mackenzie Holmes.
Well, Brendan, it's different because against Monmouth, Monmouth was missing a ton of inside shots.
Indiana has missed their last 8 field goals in a row. They have to get something going here offensively.
Right there.
And that pass made it through a couple of defenders, and Meister scores it. Jada Gwynn off to Owens. Nice bounce pass inside. Anna Walker, nice up and under move.
That's just learning. You get a shot blocked, you figure out how you're going to score again. She figured it out.
Nice pass. And another nice pass to set up Meister at the rim. Grimes taking it right at Parrish, and Meister there for the rebound.
Good luck.
Owens!
Oh.
Just short.
Great pass, great pass.
Bargesser again. That's 4 in a row right at the rim for Indiana. Limited availability, we may not see her today. Grace Berger trying to build on this 6-0 run. And yes, 8-0 run for Indiana after they had missed 8 shots in a row.
You know, try to get some good solid looks.
Yarden Garzone on the wing. They go inside, and that's Sydney Parrish. Can they convert it to points? All by herself is Anna Walker, but quickly Grace Berger there to close.
Yeah, and Parrish got her hand on the ball when she put it down.
Garzone for 3. Tennessee Tech is the top scoring team in the OVC.
There we go.
And that's who they usually lean on right there. It has been so fun to watch them on their quest. Outright Big Ten champions this year for the first time in their history. First Big Ten title in 40 years, and that's how they did it. What a great job Terry Morin has done here at Indiana.
Well, the 3-point shot always keeps you in the game and gives you the opportunity, and that's what Tennessee Tech's strengths are.
Berger's strength is that, the mid-range jumper. Berger kicks it out.
And she's a Tennessee kid, too.
She sure is. How about that inside-out action to set up Garzone? Parrish lines up for three, splashes it down. The crowd got here early at Assembly Hall. The game started at 11:30 as once again Owens just backing up and drilling a three-pointer. Mentioned earlier, all Big Ten first team 4 years in a row. Just a super senior, Grace Berger. It's been a thrill to watch her throughout her career. Really interested to see how far this Indiana team goes. Jordan Brock missing, but an offensive rebound, and Owens goes right back up with it. Offensive rebound blocked by Berger, blocked again by Berger. Of all the games that I've done over the years, I've had more people reach out to me to say, I'm a friend of Kim Roseman. She is so popular, and Owens connects. How about Owens on another three-pointer? Longtime assistant coach at Vanderbilt. And that when she was under Melanie Balkum there, they shot a lot of threes, and this team does too. Sydney Parrish scores that. A little different format this year as we'll have two regionals, one in Greenville, nice. One out on the West Coast. And a nice drive to the basket by Sydney.
Yeah, nice drive by Owens. Good job at attacking the basket. And Indiana, what do? Just rebound and run.
Three-pointer for Moore McNeil.
Tennessee Tech getting good looks. Ball's not falling right now, but them getting really nice looks.
Yeah. Berger off the ball screen.
Nice.
Whoa. Nice hezzy, but Gwynn can't convert.
Three good looks by Tennessee Tech. Just can't finish.
What a move by Scalia.
Oklahoma State and Miami, two very athletic guards. Just a fun game to watch.
Of the fourth quarter, right out of the timeout by Kiara Hill. I love what Katie Meyer, the head coach from Miami, said to us yesterday as a nice tip to set up Melissa Geary. If you want to watch Oklahoma State and Miami.
And Brenda, if you had an IU sweatshirt on, if you walked off the court, you would get a...
There's Jada Gwynn. We were talking about what a great season she has had, the 5'8 senior.
Good help. Good help side.
Parrish gets loose. Too strong from Garzone. There's Parrish. That's what she's done in the Big Ten all year long. She is that big-time energy player for Indiana.
That's so needed to take pressure off everyone else.
Gwynn taking it at Scalia. There's another mid-range jumper.
Nice.
Scalia doing what she has done best throughout her career at Minnesota before transferring here. And all the way to the basket, Bargesser, the freshman from Michigan.
An opportunity to play and contribute. Nice drive.
And Tennessee Tech's Jada Gwynn. Great season for her, that they have brought such a great history and tradition at Tennessee Tech, and now they're back in the NCAA, and everybody getting into the act, but their NCAA dreams coming to a halt as they run into the number one seed, Indiana, with the 30-point victory, advancing to the second round of the NCAA tournament with a win today over the Golden Eagles.